Anil Adhikari, aka Yama Buddha, was one of the most important or well-known rappers in Nepal. Most of his songs reflect social problems like girls trafficking, problems of street children, and others which still exist in our Nepali society. Yama Buddha started to rise his fame with his hit numbers like Sati, Yo Prasanga, Antheko Suruwat, Futpath Mero Ghar, Didi, Dutama, Audhe Chumo, and Ama. Don't tell me demise of the most talented artist who made a space to stay in the heart of every Nepalese is a great loss to the Nepali music industry. So hello and what's up beautiful people, this is All in 5 and today we'll be talking about 5 interesting facts about Yama Buddha. Number 1. Yama Buddha was son of a Nepali politician Ambika Prasad Adhikari. He was born on 30 May 1987 in Salakpur, Morang, where he lived there for a few years and moved to Kathmandu with his parents. Later, he moved back to Salakpur and stayed with his grandparents for about 2 years. During that time, he completed his grades 4 and 5 at a school in Itahari called Patibara Boarding School. Again, he moved to Kathmandu and joined a school named the Excelsior School, where he completed his SLC school leaving certificate from there and also completed his plus 2 level from the Edmark Academy. Anil Adhikari resided in North London, United Kingdom with his wife. He used to do a job in a restaurant of UK for about 2 to 3 months and later got a job of postman in one of the mail company. Yama Buddha was always thankful to his father. In one of his interviews, he said that his father had retired from his work. He used to be the president of Nepal Hotel Business Society and later he also ran a college. He had done lots of struggle and made them to reach from low level to what they were living in the present. Not only that, his mother has also involved in the politics. She has run girls hostel in her own house. Number 2. As of February 2016, Yama Buddha had managed to have over 1 million followers on Facebook and 100,000 subscribers plus on YouTube. Even though he had a huge fan base on social platform, he was a media side person. So one of the interviewers asked him about the topic of him being media side person and still got a huge followers, where Yama Buddha said that he had really done hard work and released numbers of songs where he also gave songs to others in free. So this all huge fan base or followers on social platform might be the love that he was getting in region. During his childhood, Yama Buddha always dreamed of becoming deputy superintendent of police, but later he hated his own dream when he saw the reality of police in Nepal at that time. He was always fond of writing songs or poems, but he had never dreamed of becoming a rapper in the future. He was so addicted on it that he used to write during the night time and also wrote songs instead of doing his homework. Yama Buddha wrote his first poem at grade 3, which was dedicated to his younger sister. From that time, he never stopped writing, and after completing his plus 2 level, he got the feelings of recording his rap songs, where his friends always motivated him to involve on this field. Later, he got into a bike accident and started writing numbers of songs when he was in a bed rest, which made him to realize that he was happy with the music. Number 3. This fact might be interesting for you people too, cause it was interesting for us. The name Yama Buddha, which is in heart of every Nepalese, was not created by Anil Adhikari himself. In 2007, when he involved in a bike accident, he used to do online rap battle with foreigners during his bed rest. In order to represent his nation, he kept his name Buddha in that show. But he said that he kept the name Buddha like others Nepalese did, where every Nepali people fought for this statement. Buddha was born in Nepal but didn't try to learn knowledge from him, which means that he kept the name just to prove that statement for nothing. Later, there was another rap battle show in French embassy where Yama Buddha was invited. He was supposed to do rap battle with a rapper from Nepal industry, but that guy pulled out before the battle even started. And another interesting thing is, Anil Adhikari had decided to keep his new name called Slim Boss in their rap battle, but surprisingly his name was already registered as Buddha. From that time, everybody started calling him by Buddha, where Anil Adhikari thought that this name was too religious. So he decided to add Yama in front of Buddha, which means Cloud of Death. He also said that every people on this earth were Yama Buddha because everybody got both devil and god sides. So this is how his stage name Yama Buddha was evolved. Number 4. Yama Buddha used to do a few shows with rapper Unique Poet, who was a member of the Underdogs and is also the most popular rapper in Nepal, especially among the youngsters. He actually involved in a show in order to promote the group of Unique Poet. Yama Buddha and Unique Poet used to do rap battle against each other during the practice or after the show. Such rap battle gave an idea of connecting a show called Robbers to Yama Buddha. He actually wanted to conduct a rap battle show in order to promote hip hop in Nepal. He also said that there were no any means of promotion for rappers who were doing real struggle, where lots of singers were bribing for their music video on television and also buying views, which was not completely fair. So he brought Robbers and also took participation, where nobody wanted to do rap battle against him and ended up being host of the show. Bringing a show was not only easy, he also got so many negative comments on him by people saying that Yama Buddha started to tease bad words to their children. To such negative comment, he said that it was not me who taught them bad words, but it was the society itself who taught it, and also lack of education was the main reason. Number 5. Song title Sathi is one of the most popular hits of Yama Buddha, which was released on 26 November 2011 on YouTube. As of January 29, 2021, it has 19.8 million views. Yama Buddha said that this song was written from his experience and he had also involved in drugs. One day he realized that he and his friends were moving on a completely wrong track, so he decided not to involve in drugs, and with one fine decision he stick to it. Yama Buddha has become inspiration for many people who wants to be a rapper or for those who wants to be involved in any field. His struggle and achievement always motivate us and provide hope to chase our dream, which you can really achieve it if you will. He also collaborated with international artists like Iraj, Chingy and Neha Kakkar in Nachana. Yama Buddha had done international tours in India, Australia, UK and so on. On 14 January 2017, Yama Buddha was found dead in his bathroom at around 6 a.m. It was reported that the singer committed suicide in his residence in North London. Even though you are not with us, you will always remain in our heart. Thanks for your great contribution on Nepal hip-hop community, which is completely priceless. You are the reason that we have now many talent rappers such as Unique Poet, MC Flow, B10, Lowry, and so on, and also numbers of rappers on his way. You will always be remembered, and you were the legend of Nepop. You are the legend of Nepop, and you will be the legend of Nepop. There is a 101% fact that legend never die in this whole universe, which we mean Yama Buddha never die. So these are the 5 interesting facts about Yama Buddha, and hope you guys enjoy the video. Other than this is Prasanth Tamang, narrator of All in 5, and thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Peace.